thing is, the sort of troubles we come across with the gut stuff is that it is so personalised and unique, but what are the general rules that you say to keep a healthy gut for everyone?
The general rules are, firstly, eat real food. Okay, so reduce processed foods to an absolute minimum. I'm not saying never have it, but if you do, make sure that you've got a base that is based lots of plants, lots of variety. So fruit and veg and lots of fiber. People probably need to double the amount of fiber they're having. It's amazing when people count this. We've forgotten about fiber in this obsession with sugar or fat, and that's been a big mistake. The more fiber you've got, the happier your microbes are. If you don't have fiber, they starve. So get your fiber in, then get also variety. So not just having the same prawn salad every day or the same avocados. Start mixing it up. Apples and pears, nuts and seeds, and realize that your microbes need this variety of vegetables. Different colored ones are great. Anything high in fiber, your pulses, your lentils, your beans. And then there's this whole other variety of food. As well as high fiber foods, you've got polyphenols. Do you know what they are? Heard of them?
I think you've told us this before,
Tim. Are they in blueberries?
Yes, so they're...
Well done.
So they're very, these are chemicals that highly colored foods have. And so we're talking about berries, we're talking about, you know, things like tomatoes and, but even olives have these things. So anything with polyphenols in it are food for your microbes. And in return, they produce chemicals that help your immune system, dampen it down, stop those allergies, stop that inflammation. And so go for high polyphenol stuff as well. So that includes some strange things you may not have thought about. So you've been told probably not to have coffee. Coffee turns out is healthy for you. And it has, because it's packed with polyphenols. Another one is chocolate.
Yes, Tim.
70% or more, if it's got to be dark chocolate, is packed with polyphenols and doesn't have too much sugar. So that's also good. Nuts and seeds, right? Everyone likes their peanuts and things. Yeah. Been warned off it, but actually they're really good for a source of polyphenols. Then you've got as much olive oil as you can use. Extra virgin olive oil, that's the secret of why the Mediterranean people live longer and are healthier and have healthier guts. So you've got this whole range of these, the high fiber, the high polyphenols, and variety. The other source of polyphenols I know you girls love?
Wine.
Exactly.
Yay-hey.